Okay, this is Biology 334, it's animal behavior. So today I brought my students out to the zoo to help the zoo collect data on some of their, two of their exhibits to look at the behavior. So students get an opportunity to collect data on live, cool animals, and the zoo gets to use the data that they collect.
We're studying sandcat behavior, and there's a new female in the exhibit, so we're studying how the male responds to her entering and living with them. So they are solitary animals, but she's on birth control and they're hoping to have little kittens later, but they studied the male on their own previously, so we're going to compare that data with our data right now.
So one group is looking at the rock hyrax, are these small mammals about this big, about 8 pounds, that are actually closely related to elephants, and they're looking to see if the presence of this porcupine, which is like this huge cape porcupine, if the presence of the porcupine in their exhibit is actually affecting their behavior and their use of space in the exhibit.
We are learning how to properly and accurately take recorded data on behavioral studies and learning the different styles and techniques that researchers at the zoo will use to observe the animals and better understand their behaviors and what makes them tick, why they do this, why they don't do this, stuff like that.
And so the keepers that work with these animals every day, they're the ones that came up with the research questions. So these are things that they wanted to know about in terms of helping them manage the exhibits and knowing what's best for their animals, and so, but they don't necessarily have time to collect the data themselves. So we have the opportunity and the numbers and the time to collect the data for them. And so it's a nice partnership, I think, between the zoo and our students in the class. So we'd like to do more of this kind of stuff in the future.